Hello and welcome. My name is Manuel Quintana with Pragmatic Works, and in collaboration with MAQ Software, we're bringing you today's video to showcase their most downloaded custom visual, the KPI Ticker. Now with this visual, we can take data like stock market data or any sort of data that's constantly changing over time, having consistent updates and changes, whether that be positive or negative, and showcasing it in this more of a rotation fashion. Instead of a singular KPI, you can have multiples and have them kind of interface or rotate and around. That's the biggest and coolest feature of this KPI ticker. But there's so many, and let's go discover those in Power BI. All right, so here we are in Power BI looking at the KPI ticker by MAQ Software. And you can immediately see exactly what you're talking about, having that rotation style, where I have, in this case, four different KPIs displayed at one moment, and then it slides up, and then I have my next four KPIs. And we're going to see there's a lot of things that we are in control of and can modify how this is displayed. So first and foremost, let's talk about the idea behind, of course, KPIs, those indicators, which are key things. As we can see, we have positive green arrows pointing up, negative red arrows pointing down, and occasionally we have a blue line, which represents no change. Now, the way we can do this, as we can see as we move into this example, this top item does not leverage it, so it's not required. The minimum requirements for leveraging this KPI ticker is to just have a name of your KPI, which as you can see is mapped just here on the right, and then the current value. So in this case, we're just really just giving almost like a mini display of like multiple cards, the name of our KPI, and the value, which is usable, which is pretty neat, but of course we can extend this much more and truly get those indicators going, which is what we're seeing down below, which we've mapped one additional field here, the KPI status. And what's important to note is that for this column, the values that are going to be accepted and are going to be leveraged here are either a value of 1, which represents a positive increase, then that's going to be tied to our upwards arrow, which is green, but we'll talk about how we can change that. We're going to have negative 1 for our down arrow, which we've defined currently as red, for that negative change, and then 0 represents no change. So that is what that column should be that you're mapping to KPI status. And as I mentioned, we can change what those colors correlate to. So yes, 1 is positive and it's an up arrow, but do I want green? Let's say yes, but I don't like the idea of blue representing no change. Let's go to a more traditional stoplight and let's make that yellow. So with the visual selected, we can go over to the format area, and under indicators, you're going to get the three items we just spoke about, positive, negative, and neutral. Now in our case, we do have it as yellow already, but let's say I wanted to change it up. Let's reverse what I was mentioning, and let's say I want to go with blue, make it a little fancier. There's not as many no changes, but just with that selection, anything that is identified at a row level having a zero value will now have a blue line representing no change. So we are in complete control of modifying any and all of these items and access to the entire color wheel, which is quite fantastic. Now about these KPIs, there's some additional things we can do for configuring them. As you can see in the very top example, I'm changing the amount of tiles that are going to be displayed per rotation. So right now I've set this to 2. We can change this to 4, to 3. Definitely dependent on how much area you have here will make this more or less critical here. But if we go to the format area and we go here under formatting, we can see there's this KPI count area. So if I just change it from 2 to 3, we have 3 tiles per rotation. So we're in complete control of this. And of course, we're talking all about formatting for the tiles. We can control the count here as well. Still in the formatting section, as you can see, where we are controlling the count, we can of course change the background color, which we've set here to this nice sky blue. And I've also gone through the motion of modifying the value as well as the name font color to white. Where it was this blue color, as you can see above, I made it white just to change it up and to show that we can do this as well as modifying font family as well as size. So a lot of different ways we can display this. Now beyond just looking at what the value is and what the change has been made, we can add in a layer to show percentages. This is going to be called enabling delta, and it's simply just a toggle box that we can enable when we select the visual and we go over to the format area. In the very same section we were tinkering with, formatting, there is just a toggle bar. Enable data, on or off. It is off, no percentages. If it's on, you have them, giving you another degree of explicitness to understanding this data, just making that KPI so much more effective. As well, we can go on and not only configure the tiles, how much space to take, how many tiles we want, we can also control the animation style of this. So as we've been looking at all of these, having this vertical rotation where it's shifting from top to bottom, we can also modify this and go horizontal if we so choose. So by selecting the visual, hitting the format in the animation section, we can go and say horizontal scroll. So now it's going to rotate left to right, scrolling. Now I do have this sorted by the name field. That's how I'd want it, by company. And you can see it's going side to side. And it's happening and based off of the duration. So we can modify this. If we were to up this maybe to 3 seconds, there'll definitely be a noticeable change between this top KPI ticker and the bottom, because we're giving our users more time. But if we want to give them the ultimate sense of control, we can also turn on this capability where we can enable a selection bar. And I'll minimize animation because it is in the carousel option. By turning this on, you'll see that we are given two little arrows here to the right and to the left. And by selecting those arrows, we actually control the direction and can move through the various KPIs. So you give them the control. And as you can see, as I stop leveraging and taking advantage of those controls, it goes back into the standard rotation every 3 seconds. Also, thinking about this, we just changed it to going horizontal. If you wanted to go vertical but have it instead be stacked, another option. Here I'm going to take this KPI ticker. Under animation, we can see that there's option for a vertical stack. And usually I want to realign this. So for me, I'm going to bring this in a little bit. So you can see I'm going to bring this in, give it some nice bordering, and I'm going to extend it just like this. This is only showing two KPIs, but now it's going to rotate. Now you'll notice though, there's also a different styling where the top one is called slide and wait. This one's doing nothing, and that's under style. Still under the animation section, we can choose, here's no animation. Slide and wait is what we've been seeing for the duration of this demo, but we also have fade. So you can choose exactly how this is moving in between these different tiles. So choices can be had here. Lastly, we're going to look at dimension and formatting. This is just, we talked about the number of tiles, but also how much room should each tile take up. By default, we have what's known as responsiveness set to on. So when you select any of these visuals, once again going into display, you have a section called dimensions. Responsiveness basically extends these to take up the entirety of what you're using as far as space-wise. If I turn this off, we go to these default dimensions of 290 by 80, which we are in complete control of and we can modify. I want less width to these tiles. I want to go a little bit smaller on this item here for the height. We can definitely do that. Maybe I'll extend it here and go a little bit higher. So we can do this manually, or once again, you can turn on responsiveness and have it take up the entirety of the area that you have drawn with this KPI ticker visual. So hopefully you enjoyed this video and thanks for watching. If you have any questions about this visual or need a similar business solution, feel free to contact MAQ Software at sales@maqsoftware.com. As well, for any of your Power BI training needs, be sure to reach out to us at Pragmatic Works by emailing training@pragmaticworks.com.